Thank you so much, Pawichak, our able moderator, for this morning. Let me say a few things before I conclude the meeting, and also say thanks to our speakers and participants. In my opinion, one of the most important messages we hear this morning is that palm oil has led vegetable oils by a verifiable example of sustainability. From there, SPOC takes another lead by developing a global framework for all palm oil producing countries to follow. This framework is not meant to be a certification scheme, but it can inspire palm oil producing countries to have their own schemes adapted to their national needs and requirements. We are mindful as well that this framework will be interpreted differently by many parties, but I think, you know, the most important one and the most important objective is that the framework should be the basis for further dialogue. I think we have heard a lot of suggestions from our two main speakers today on the importance of dialogue forward. There are three takeaways, Pawichak, from our webinar, in my opinion. First is that, is it inevitable for all vegetable oils to have sustainability standards, as the subtitle of our webinar suggests? If we are true to our commitment to SDGs and other international commitments, then all vegetable oils should have their own standard. Sustainability is a norm for all oils. This global framework can be used to develop one, including through the auspices of the UN. With this framework, palm oil producing countries, through SPOC, would like to promote collaboration and not competition among edible oils. It is not a coincidence that the first principle of the framework is about partnership. UNDP's participation in this discussion sends a clear signal to us that towards the direction, or in UNDP's work, for the framework to be the basis for transformative dialogue to progress with SDGs and improve palm oil governance. The contribution of all stakeholders, such as a prominent organization, Solidaridad, is indispensable to achieve our common objective and ambition, a global standard for all oils. Some ideas on how we can define global has been highlighted by Dr. Satadru for our future consideration and discussion. Second, perhaps, is that what is the next step for palm oil producing countries? Asia to lead, as suggested by Dr. Satadru. India, Indonesia, and Malaysia have shown an excellent example to have mutual support and recognition of their mandatory schemes called EPOS for India, ISPO for Indonesia, and MSPO for Malaysia. This example should not only be applied between palm oil producing countries, but also between palm oil producing countries and producers of other major oils. Palm oil producing countries should consolidate their position first to allow wider dialogue. That way, we can address the long imbalance, scrutiny on the sustainability of palm oil, but not on other oils. The third and the last, perhaps, Pawichak, is that is there a viable solution for palm oil major producing and also major consuming countries? I think it has been also discussed quite extensively by our two speakers. Discrimination or sanction, as we have seen from some major consumers, in the name of narrow concept of sustainability, such as deforestation, neither acceptable nor workable and fair. That way, the way forward is to co-create solution by strengthening sustainability standard using SDGs as the main parameters. Palm oil producing countries have their own national schemes, and it is incumbent for major consumers to accept that fact and even help improve the schemes in a spirit of partnership, but not to unilaterally decide on what is considered sustainable or not. That is not our approach or a step that we can accept. Finally, our special appreciation and thanks to Pak Agus Prabowo from UNDP Indonesia, our good respected friend, Dr. Satadru, and to our consultant, Dr. Jeff Haragoski. It would be a remiss for me not to thank all participants, active participants, and also the SPOC Secretariat colleagues for this successful webinar. Thank you all and keep safe. Thank you.